Hey, welcome back to my channel. My name is Lagracia Eksteen, and my apologies for being this late. Second of all, I lost some footage, it seems, between transferring videos from one device to another. My apologies. Like, I don't think it will make a difference to the video. So you'll just imagine certain things and just fill in the blanks, but the essence of this meal will come together. Also, this is not a tutorial, it's not a recipe, so it's just what I made for supper, and you can try it or you don't have to try it. The reason why I am chatting to you guys is because this video, or a video, almost did not happen today. I was at the point where I was like, I just don't have capacity to upload a video today. And I thought back to the reason why I started doing this little challenge for myself. I don't like participating in things that starts with that is a challenge. The reason for that is because I dive head in first, and then I struggle to find my feet, and then it overwhelms me and I become despondent, and then I don't complete it. So I've stayed away from accepting challenges. This, though, has been long overdue. I've been wanting to do a marathon of uploading videos since last year sometime, and every time I get close to doing it, I would find a reason to talk myself out of it. And July, I decided, you know what, I'm just gonna do this. I'm just gonna do this. I need to do this for myself. I need to get over this. And it so happens that Klantis is hosting a challenge as well, and I decided, like, okay, this is the sign. Let me just do it, because I'm not doing it on my own. Then I see other people doing it as well, and that helps me stay on track and it helps me stay accountable. So I have not officially called this a challenge because of what I just explained. I would l really love to see this through. The last time I did a marathon of vis not visits. I'm thinking of gym. A marathon of videos was either for Vlogtober or for Vlogmas, and I know that on day 8, on either one of the two, I fell off. And yesterday was the 8th day, so I've uploaded for the 8th day, and today is the 9th day. So this is like my Achilles heel, if I can call it that. So this is the point where I usually fizzle out. The other two times, like, things happened. Like, I got really, really busy. The other time, I was very, very sick and I couldn't. And but today I decided I'm not gonna let this stop me. I'm not gonna be afraid of going past this point. I am going to give myself the opportunity to try. And I was extremely busy today. I was really, very busy today, and I was cold, and like, technology wasn't working with me, and our Wi-Fi was down. It is just a hot mess. There was every reason for me to give myself the day off, but I just wanted to fight for myself. Like, I just wanted to fight for to see this through, you know. I just wanted to prove to myself that great things can happen and will happen when I don't give up, you know. And I know that this is very I, and this is very me, but it is a self-reflection, and I'm sorry about that. Also, I was thinking back at the amount of times that I stopped doing what I need to get done because I am doing something for my family or doing something for someone else. And I remember a few years ago, I read something that says, like, you need to start treating yourself as someone you love. And I don't treat myself like that all the time. Like, I've gotten used to treating myself like a second-class citizen, you know, not as someone that I love. Because for the people that I love, I go all out for. Like, I really try my best. I stop everything that I'm doing. I'll go the extra mile for them. And I've forgotten how to treat myself like that over the last few years. So I really want to get back to that place where I look at myself and I'm proud of what I've done. I'm proud of what I've accomplished. I'm proud of setting boundaries. I'm proud of going after what I wanted, because I don't know if this has anything to do with the scripture, but what pops into my head right now is the Bible says faith without works is dead. And works in this instance for me, and I might be wrong, is the physical work, actually putting in the work. Yes, we will never be justified. We will never be saved by the amount of work that we're doing. But I have so much faith in all of this, but my works are lacking. So this is the end product. Like, this food was really good. My kids enjoyed it. I enjoyed it. It is delicious, because there's still some left. And it is a very simple meal, but it tasted so, so good. And it filled our tummies and it kept us warm. And I am happy. So we've come to the end of the video. Thank you so, so much for watching. Thank you for listening to my TED Talk. And I will see you all in the next video. Goodbye.